and Sergeant Major Miller assumes his position of leadership at 2MIG Information Group. Knowing the importance of your divine presence in our lives, we ask for continued blessing on Sergeant Major Turner and his wife Heather, his two daughters, Molly and Courtney. May his family continue to be a rock of strength and resilience through this time of change. Thank you for his hard work, determination, and steady leadership that he puts into every day in the same way. His wisdom, strength, and character, the key to kill nature, model what the Marine Corps expects of the Sergeant Major. And now, as Sergeant Major Miller assumes his new leadership position, we ask that you bless him and his family as he works with the world to guide you. Give him the wisdom to provide our commanding officer the right guidance, the right time, as he confronts the many challenging situations that he'll face. Finally, bless all Marines and family and sailors here and their families. We ask all these things in your most holy name. Amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Present day parades in the Marine Corps have their basis in both history and tradition. The mass formation of troops on one long line in close interval made possible the massive firepower from muzzle-loaded muskets of yesterday. In those early days, the line of battle was just that, a line of two or three ranks, and looked much like the parade formation you will see today. The adjutant forms the line of battle. The adjutant for today's ceremony is Master Sergeant Edgar R. Raphael. Thank you. units are being aligned from left to right in order to get them in their exact position for the parade.
Thank you.
parade adjutant now presents the assembled command to the commander of troops.
Thank you.
1942, Sergeant Major Wesley O turned his second subject relief effective 1321 April 2023. Will relieve of your duties as a Sergeant Major of the 2 MIG Information Group. Signed, David H. Berger, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Ready to assume the duty. He understands the operational art and multi-domain coalition and joint war fighting. He drove the diverse elements of the 2 Marine Expeditionary Information Group to synthesize their technical capabilities, bringing them together with unified identity and a new sense of community. An exceptional communicator, he is an approachable leader of presence and compassion. He empowers diversity of talent and of thought, and he addresses each unique person's situation in its own appropriate context. A master of the complex resources within the group, his advice was critical to the global deployment of hundreds of Marines and their exquisite capabilities. Sergeant Major turns to professionalism, personal initiative, and total dedication to duty reflect great credit on him and the keeping of the highest traditions of the Marine Corps and United States Naval Service. For the President, signed David A. Ognon, Lieutenant General, United States Marine Corps, Command General to Marine Expeditionary Force.
I would offer, if you'd ever see a Marine in general, or any of these Marines in particular, seek them out and just talk to them. The various items that they have to speak of are just great. I'm in interest of this and me keeping on the deal and not going into tangents. I'm gonna keep it to the three B's as I learned from one of my mentors. Boss, boys, and my babe. Those are the three. I've had the opportunity to work with two fine commanders while assigned to the MIG. I've had Colonel Russell and now Colonel Takaki. Both of these gentlemen have pushed the limits of my self-proclaimed title of the hardest working Marine in the Corps. By virtue of the majority of my time, I've spent with Colonel Takagi. But every day has presented itself as a learned experience for myself, because every day in the MIG is just different. Sir, thank you for the opportunity to harness your craft to commandership. Another mission I had while assigned in the MIG, you know, this was like the extra prize you get, was being the man sergeant major. I've had the opportunity to serve with two fine brigadier generals. I had General Henderson and now General Pretty. They took me in, and I'm just so grateful for the opportunity to work with these general officers. As I hinted in the beginning, these men and women who fill the ranks of the units that comprise the MIG are some of the most talented humans I've ever encountered. I would publicly thank a lot of people here today, but in interest of the Marines behind me, I offer for the reception you come up and I can, you know, shake your hand, look you in the portholes of life, and just tell you what you've done for me and how special you are to my successes. To my family, my tripod of success, I would like to offer public acknowledgement of my sincere appreciation to your support and your resilience throughout these many years. I love you deeply, and I hope that you know just how much. To my wife, the glue that holds everything together, also known as Household Six, also known as the sandwich bagger. We have this little saying in our household when it's orders time, when we say we have to have the sandwich talk. And my kids know it's not the good sandwich. It's that sandwich that everyone has to take a bite of, and I always tell them I'll take the largest bite, but everyone's going to have to bite it. You guys are awesome. To close this out, I hope we can talk to more at the reception. Probably take a little pause for the cause while we stuff our faces and enjoy some beverages at the bar. But other than that, ladies and gentlemen, I'm done for today. I offer you. I did not talk about Josh Schneller. I did exactly what I didn't want to do. This young man coming in to take the MIG has just been phenomenal. He up and comer. I know that he's going to take us into where we need to be, and these Marines are in great hands. Ladies and gentlemen, Joshua Miller.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Central High 9, good afternoon. Sergeant Major Wilson, Master Chief Urbana, thank you. I'm super proud to be part of this MEF and everything that it represents. I ask for these orders, and I hope to make you proud. To Colonel Scott, thank you for the kind words. And to all the commanders, chiefs of staff, sergeants, major, command master chiefs, master sergeants, all commanders, senior enlist leaders, everyone, thank you for being here. Ritter General Pretty, thank you, sir. And we'll work together, General Neville, thank you, sir. And, you know, the Miller family, we're a big family of yours, and Joanne and the girls, likewise to Dylan and Sophie, who came out here today. And to everyone, our most distinguished guest today is Sergeant Major Wes Turner. Right, Wes, your impact on me was profound and immediate. Our turnover was smooth, and here in just a few moments, at the hands of Master Morales, our drill master, Sergeant Mormon, commander of troops, unit leaders, and all the MIG staffers that don't get the attention they deserve that made this thing possible. These Marines are going to march by here, and that's going to be it. That'll be a wrap. That'll be another successful tour for you. And then you get to go home and enjoy some time with your family. Much deserved. Well done. To my wife, Jenny, 21 years. Here's a couple more here with Carolina MATF, where we love, where we've raised our boys. And we're sitting right there behind her with my dad, Wayne Miller. Thanks for being here, Dad, and sharing this moment with me. To my boys, I expose you to events like this to show you what service looks like. And you may choose to do this in uniform or not, but just know that that is your calling to live a life of service. Excuse me, everyone. Marine sailors of 2MIG Information Group, your reputation and performance here up to this date gives me purpose and a life worth living.